Subscribe to this channel Techie Paddy and click that bell icon button to be the first ones to receive the latest updates about the latest videos on this channel Techie Paddy. Hey guys, this is Noel Padgaonkar from Techie Paddy. So in this video, I'll be describing the various types of warning lights which are found in your normal car dashboard. So sit back and enjoy this video. Let's go! So before I begin, let me tell you that I'm only gonna go through the basic warning lights. I'm not gonna go through the various other types of warning lights which are found in different types of cars. Only the basics ones which are found in all of the cars. And for this demonstration, I'll be using my Skoda Fabia 1.6 liter petrol engine vehicle. So let's begin by talking about the various warning lights. So before we begin, let me give you the overview of the various warning lights which are available on your car's dashboard or your speedometer. So for that, let me just turn on the ignition. And you can see on your screen that there are so many dashboard lights and your warning lights which are available. Now, when you start your car, ensure that some of these warning lights should go off. For example, right now I have pulled the handbrake. That's why this warning light is right now on. When I just pull it down, this will just go off like that. But you should also ensure that when you switch on the ignition of your car, just like this, all of these warning lights should go away. This indicates that your car has no faults in it. So now let me just turn it off and now talk about the various warning lights. So let's start with the basic one. So you guys might be knowing that this is for the right indicator and this is for the left indicator. So that's all. And also you guys might be knowing about this one. So this is for the handbrake. When you just pull it down, it will go off, and when you just pull it up, it will come back on again. So it indicates that your handbrake is on or off. The next thing is this symbol. So people mistake it by saying that this is the symbol of the engine and it is related to the engine oil or something. But no guys, this is a exhaust management system warning light. So what happens is this will come on when the ignition is switched on, and when you turn on the car, you might have seen that these warning lights disappear. But if you're driving your idling or something and suddenly it just comes on, that means there is a fault in the exhaust management system and it needs to be inspected. So it will enable some program in itself which will allow you to take your vehicle to the nearest service center for getting it inspected. The next thing is this one. So people are familiar with this one. This is for the battery, but when you switch on the car, this indicates goes off, and if it does not go off, it indicates that there is some loss in the voltage in the battery and the battery needs to be inspected as soon as possible. Now let me show you the other indicator which you might have not seen right now on the screen right now. So let me just turn it again. So if you can see this one is for the airbag light. Like for example, if your car is equipped with the airbag system, this will indicate that your airbag is on. But if this will keep on glowing, that means there is a fault in the airbag and it needs to be inspected. So the next thing is this. This is called the anti-locking braking system symbol. So this is the ABS symbol. What this does is anti-locking brake system are present in some of your vehicles and it prevents the vehicle from locking the wheels at a time. Like if you lock the wheels, so there can be some skidding or something. So this will prevent it. But this light, if it comes on when you're driving or something, that means there are two possibilities. Number one, there is a failure in the ABS system and your car will not use the ABS system, but it will use a normal braking system. So there might be chances that your wheels might get locked. Or the second possibility is there is some faulty sensor which needs to be replaced. If you see any of these warning lights, ensure that you take it to the nearest service center and get it checked. So now I will show you the next warning light. And this, if you can see, this is the warning light for electro-hydraulic power steering. So what does this do exactly, this electro-hydraulic power steering? You might be knowing that every car has a power steering system. So they can be electric, hydraulic, or electric-hydraulic. So this comes on, that means the system is perfectly working. And when it goes off after some time, that means all right. But now if you try to move your steering wheel, when it is in idling mode right now, like I'm not even switched on the engine and it's in the ignition mode. So your steering will still be tight. That means your hydraulic pump has not even started. So when you start your car, you'll be able to move your steering freely. But when you're driving and this comes on, that means there is some problem in this electronic hydraulic pump and your steering becomes a bit stiffer and it is very difficult to steer. So ensure that you get that corrected, because it is going to cause a lot of accidents if your steering gets locked up or something because of this issue. Now the other system is this one. So people will be aware with this one. This is the fuel warning light. That means if you are running on fuel, less fuel, like for example, I am on 1/4 of fuel, and if the level drops at a particular level, this will show reserve. That means this much amount of fuel is remaining and it needs to be checked immediately. So check immediately means it needs refueling. So the next thing is this one. This is for the coolant temperature, and you guys might be knowing that every car has a coolant to cool its engine. So if this coolant temperature rises, then this light will come on indicating that your car is heating up. You need to stop your car immediately. My car does not have a temperature gauge, but some of the cars come with the temperature gauge, as you can see on the screen. So you can see one is the cold and one is the hot. But this light is also present there indicating once it reaches the hot sign, that means the H sign. So the next thing is the lights. So when you switch on the lights, and if you can see on the screen that this is for the beam light, and this is for the normal lights, and this is for the front fog light, and you can see on the screen that this is for the rear fog light. The next warning light is this one. So this indicates your door is open or it has not been closed properly. So when you close the door just like this, this warning light goes off, and when you just open the door, it'll just come on again. So that's all about all these warning lights in the system of your car. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'm pretty sure now I'll be able to indicate what is wrong with the car if this warning light comes on or that warning light comes on. So if you like this video, please hit the like button, and if you haven't subscribed to TechiePaddy, this is the first time. My name is Mohit Padgaonkar and this is my channel TechiePaddy. Do subscribe, and if you have any comments or any feedback, please do leave it in the comment section below. Please share this video, and I'll see you guys in my next video.